Hello and welcome again, class 6. This is the second class of your maths algebra, and today also I will continue with the alphabetic symbols or algebraic variables. Today I'll show you some more sums, a little bit complicated one also, but with the help of this class you can understand clearly how you have to work on or you have to solve, you can solve this algebraic variable sums, the symbols used in algebraic variables. So let's get started. Now suppose I'll give you some sums like 5 more than 5 more than the sum of 5 + a and b. In this way you will solve the sums. Again another sum, suppose 4 less than 3/7 of p, it is given that 4 less than 3/7 of p, 4 less than 3/7 of p. So what you will write? 3/7 of p means 3 by 7 into p, that is 3p by 7, and 4 less than that means minus 4. 4 less means minus 4. 4 should be subtracted from 3/7 of p. This is how the algebraic variable will be represented through a symbol. Next sum, 1/10 of the product of A and B. 1/10 of the product of A and B. Product of A and B means A into B, that is AB. Now 1/10 of AB. 1/10 of AB can be written as 1 by 10 into AB, or it can be written as AB by 10. AB by 10. This is the answer. AB by 10. 1/10 of the product of AB, that is AB divided by 10. Let's move on to some more sums. Suppose it is given to you, 36. The value, this is sum number 4. The value of Q is not less than 36. What will you write? Q less than 36 and Q not less than 36 means, which means Q is not less than 36. This is how we will do it. Again, if it is given the value of Q is greater than equal to or less than equal to, then what will you write? The value of sum number 5 of Q is greater than or equal to 12. The value of Q is greater than or equal to 12. The value of Q is greater than or equal to. Equal to means equal to sign also you have to give under this greater than sign. So this is called greater than and equal to q. The value of q is greater than equal to 12. The value of q is greater than equal to 12. This is how you will solve the sums. Now coming to sum number 6. Sum number 6, if it is given that the value of y, if it is given that the value of y is less than or equal to 20. How will you express this? The value of y is less than or equal to 20. So y, the value of y will be less than 20, and if equal to is there, less than or equal to, you have to place the equal to sign just under the less than symbol. This is how you will solve the sums. Very quickly we will move on to the next sum. Suppose if it is given that value of x is not equal to 27. Not equal to is given over here. If the value of x would have been equal to 27, then we have written x equal to 27. But mind you, it is given that the value of x is not equal to 27. In that case, what we have to do is, we have to write equal to sign and not that equal to sign. This is called the value of x is not equal to 27. The value of x is not equal to 27. Next, suppose it is written that 5 times a is less than 10 times b. 10 times b, 5 times a is less than 10 times b. How will you do this? 5 times, now times represent multiplication. Times represent multiplication. So 5 times a means 5 into a, that is 5a. And 10 times b represent 10 into b, that is 10b. So 5 times a is less than 10 times b. That means 10b minus 5a. 10b minus 5a. 10b means 10 into b, whereas 5a means 5 into a. So 10b minus 5a. 5 times a is less than 10 times b. This is how we will solve the sums based on algebraic variables using the alphabetic symbols. So in my next class, I will come up with a different topic of this symbol chapter. Till then, practice the sums, follow the PDF that is given, download the PDF from the link that is given attached with the video. Till then, goodbye.